Hey there guys, what's going on? This is Buzzertech here and welcome to Tuesday Tutorials, and in this video I will tell you guys on how to make a channel art or banner easily with Adobe Photoshop CS6. So I thought of making this video because beginners on YouTube don't know on how to make a channel art which can have a better impact upon their audience. So I hope people watching this video will get a little help as they kick off their channel. So before beginning the tutorial, if you haven't subscribed to my channel then do subscribe now and leave a like down below so that we could make it to 30 likes. So let's have a look. So first of all, open your Photoshop and then go to File and then download a template. I have given the link in the description and download the template from there. Okay, so this is the template, and then what you have to do is that you have this, select this background and then go to image, then adjustment, and then hue and saturation. And over here you can change the color of the background or the all the contents over here by checking this colorize, and then you can select any color you want. Like I will choose red one, a red color, and then I will increase the saturation like this. Increase the saturation and increase the lightness a bit if you want, and I will click on OK. And once it's done, now the next step is to go to your browser and then go to images.google.com, and here you can search for grunge, wooden or rock texture, and I will just search for a grunge texture. Okay, so here are many kind of grunge texture over here, and you can actually choose, like you can even add something like red grunge texture, white grunge texture, or any color you want for the grunge texture. So I have already downloaded one, so I will just quickly move on and to Photoshop, and I will go to File, Place, and search the file where you have saved it. Like I have it on my desktop, and then place it, and this is a white kind of a texture. So what you have to do is just bring it like this over here, and you see this box rectangle over here, and just place it in the limits where the lines, the guides are shown. You have to just resize it in these guides. Okay, so I will just drag it like this, and once you have this, then stretch it like this, check it, and be sure you have this texture over the background viewable. And then once it is over here, now you can do is that set a blend mode. So you can either go to effects and then do blending options, or you select this, and then here is the blending options over here. So I will choose green, and so that looks a bit not professional, so I will just bring the opacity a bit down, and that looks a bit good. I will just keep it to like around 36 or 35, so that looks a bit good. And now just zoom in it a bit to check how it looks. So you can zoom by clicking on Control or Option on Mac, and Control on Windows, and then plus sign. So you're like this, zooming in, and it looks good. Okay, so I will just zoom back by clicking on Control O. So once you have this, now again go to your browser and then go to dafont.com. This is an optional step if you want a good font. So this is dafont.com, and over here I recommend you to go in fancy and then retro, because retro style is very awesome for me. But you can choose, there are a number of categories over here. You can choose any one of them, and you can get your own custom fonts over here. And I will just go to retro. I'll just scroll down. You can see many of these options over here, and this one looks you see in WrestleMania, this looks a bit good. Atlantic Cruise is also very good. I will just scroll down and find one. I will be back once I find my font. Okay, so I think Geomancy looks a bit good, so I'll just click on this download button, and then it will pursue you to download the file, so you can save it anywhere. I'll just save it in a folder and click on save. So once the file is downloaded, just click on this and then go to show in folder. So once you are in the folder, This file is actually a zip file, so you can either use WinRAR to unzip it or extract it, and you can even use WinZip. So I have WinRAR on my computer, so I will extract it with WinRAR. So right click on it and extract here. So it has extracted, and we have this two fonts font file over here. So install both of them by clicking on it, left clicking on it using your mouse, and install the font like this. Click on install. So now I have installed both the fonts. Now I close this folder and I'll go back to Photoshop. Now over here you can add any text you want. I will add my username. Okay, now we will change the font. So select the text, and the name of the font was starting from G, that is Geomancy, and here it is, Geomancy, and it is set on extra bold. So just select this text and just go to this and just drag it like this, and you will see the decrease in the size of the text. And now just place it wherever you want. I will place it over here and I will click on OK, and let the text be white, and here let the text be smooth. So once you have did this, now select the text, and I will select a part of my text like this, and I'll click on this character window, and over here I will just select this one that is underline, and I will select yes. And that basically does is that it gives kind of a design to the text. So I did like this. This is very simple. You can even drag something like a rectangle and beneath your text and make it look good. So once you are done with that, I will just change the color of the text. I will just change the color of this text, and I will click on this effects tab now, and I will go to gradient overlay. Now over here, let the gradient be like this only, and just bring the opacity bit down to something like 35, and that doesn't look that great. So I will do is that I will click on this, and we'll make the black to something like a gray, light gray, and that looks a bit good. And I'll increase it like this. And now you have to do is go to stroke and add a little bit of stroke, like around 4 or maybe 3, and now go to drop shadow and add a little bit of drop shadow, but let the blend mode be normal and change the opacity to 100, and now make the distance around like 10, and spread increase. You can just play around with the spread and increase the size a bit, and then click on OK, and then you have this text. I will just change this color of this tech kind of stuff, and I'll make it completely dark red, and I will click on OK, and that looks a bit good. So the next step is adding a tagline. So it's an optional step. If you have something like a tagline or a phrase for your channel, then you can add it something like over here under the buzzer, because and that will actually look good. And I don't have a tagline for now. So once you add the tagline, the next step is to go to Google Images, and then you can search for something like a character of the game you play or the stuff you do on your channel. Like my channel is completely like a PC and stuff, so I will just add something like a computer PNG, and search for a PNG file for your character of the game you play or some object. Okay, so once you have this, you can choose any one of them, and I've selected this one, so I'll click on this, and you see this ongoing loading process over here. Let this be done, and you see this, if you have the check marks over here, then yes, this is a transparent image. So right click on it and then click on save image as. So once you have that saved on your computer, you can go back to Photoshop and then go to File, and then Place, and then search for the file where you saved it, okay? And then, so it's on my canvas. So I will just do is that I will just bring the size a bit down, or like this, and I'll click on okay. And what I will do is that I will just decrease the size of the text by clicking on by selecting the text and clicking on Ctrl T, and just going to the edges and then shift and then just drag it like this. And another warning for you guys, that be sure you have your text and your stuff in this rectangle over here, like this rectangle, and because this is the only safe area your image, your banner will appear on mobile devices, and this is the area, and this is the actual safe area where the PC, where your banner will appear on your PC. So if you want it to be of optimum, then be sure you have this in this safe area. And so I will just place the text properly, and then just I will place the transparent computer properly like this. Now I will decrease the opacity a bit. Okay, so that looks a bit good. Now you can do is that you can even add your social media's link over here, like so. When we zoom out of it, you can see it looks a bit good. And if you do something like a customization, more customization, like adding some more social medias, then it will look more better. So once you have this done, I will just keep it simple. And now I'm done with this banner. So I will go to File, then Save As, and then choose the format to JPEG, and I will save it at a. So once you're done with it, click on OK, and your banner is saved. So that's it, you're done with the banner, and now you can go to YouTube and upload it. Thanks for watching, you awesome people. Be sure to share this video with your friends on Facebook, Twitter, Google+, etc. Help my channel grow by hitting that red hotbox subscribe button. And I hope you have a great day. This is Buzzertech, and I see you all.